In only 21 hours, lava from Iceland's latest eruption has covered a stunningly large area. I estimate the current figure to total 7.59 square kilometers or 2.93 square miles and involve as much as 30 million cubic meters of molten rock. Thankfully, the existing lava lobes, which have approached two major points of infrastructure, have seemingly ceased their forward motion, but there is still an uneasy situation for those who live on the farm known as Hraun. In the last 20 hours, the lava flowed at a rate as high as 800 meters an hour, with the southern lobe advancing 4,400 meters in that time span. It then came to a halt a mere 110 meters northwest of Route 427. Declining eruptive activity means this lava flow is unlikely to advance any further, meaning it probably won't destroy Hraun or enter the ocean and cause further problems via hydrochloric acid production. However, this now cooling lobe of lava is still producing large volumes of carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, and hydrogen sulfide, the latter two of which are highly lethal at a concentration of 100 parts per million. Even if the eruption was to end right now, the owners of this farm might not be able to immediately return until gas emissions decline to safe levels. Otherwise, the lava barriers which confronted this lava flow performed their job quite well, not failing, and successfully diverting molten rock away from six residential structures which, had the lava wall not been there, would have been destroyed. To the northwest, lava flows thankfully did not diverge towards central Grindavik, instead heading southwards. Just as I predicted, molten rock produced a lobe which advanced 2,800 meters westwards the Svartsengi geothermal power plant, once again overflowing Road 43. When this initially occurred, the heat of the lava burned a portion of the natural petroleum products that compose asphalt in these roads, creating a thick black plume. There was a concern for some time that Grindavik would be cut off by every single access road, but thankfully this did not occur. While one of three major roads was cut off by lava, a further major road and two minor roads to the west of the town experienced damage as they subsided slightly. The extent of the damage near the golf course on Road 425 is unclear at this time, but it would be best to consider that road as currently impassable. Everyone at the Blue Lagoon, the Svartsengi geothermal power plant, and Grindavik were all successfully evacuated before lava cut off any roads. While peak activity yesterday involved a 3,500 meter or 11,500 foot long fissure which simultaneously erupted in 9 segments, there is now only 2 segments which remain active. These two southern fissures are now only erupting at a minor rate, perhaps around 15 to 25 cubic meters per second. The expected eruption progression will soon cause one of the two fissures to become inactive, followed by only a single point source on the southern fissure weakly erupting. Because of this, I do not expect eruptive activity to continue beyond 35 additional hours from now. I want to take this time to thank all of the employees and volunteers who worked around the clock to repair and build new lava walls while this eruption was ongoing. It is through your hard work that many structures were saved.